愿主与你们同在，
与你的心灵同在。
恭读圣若望福音。
主愿光荣归于你。
一周的第一天清晨，天还没亮，玛利亚·马达勒纳来到坟墓那里，看见墓门的石头已经挪开了，就跑去告诉西门·伯多禄和耶稣所爱的那个门徒，对他们说，有人从坟墓中把主搬走了，不知道把他放在哪里了。伯多禄和那另一个门徒就动身往坟墓那里去，两个人一起跑，但是另一个门徒比伯多禄跑得快，先到了坟墓那里，但是他并没有进去，只是附身向里面看，看见脸部已放在地上。西门·伯多禄随后也到了，走进坟墓，看见脸部已放在地上，也没有见耶稣头上的那块头巾卷着放在另一处，没有和那布放在一起。那时候先来到坟墓的那个门徒也进去了，一看见就相信了。他们那时候还不明白，耶稣必须从死者中复活的那段圣经。基督的福音。
基督，我们赞美你。
昨晚的福音跟今天的福音有什么分别？昨晚我们读到的就是三位女的门徒，他们就去坟墓要覆摸基督的遗体，但是他的反应是什么？虽然他们看见有一个尖子说，你们所找的人已经复活了，但是他们没有写到他们相信，什么都没有写，只是写他们惊恐害怕，相信这个字没有出现。今天的福音就是，当玛利亚·马德勒纳到了坟墓的时候，她只是看到石头挪开，她没有进去，反应就是我要赶快去告诉别人先，因为怕有人偷基督的遗体把他带走了，所以这两个门徒就赶快跟他一起去。昨晚我讲到耶稣的时代，女生的见证是没有什么价值的，所以你看伯多禄跟耶稣所喜爱的门徒一起来，他是相信不相信玛利亚·马德勒纳是另外一回事，他们可能是好奇，因为没有人会乱乱说话的，所以他们就跑到。如果他们两个一起跑，当然两个会一起到的，但是另外一个到先，因为他比较年轻， 我们要知道伯多禄是比耶稣所喜爱的门徒是比较老一点，所以当然年轻的比较有力，比较有力气跑。但是奇怪的就是他到了坟墓他没有进去，为什么？他找到他应该进去吧。有些人就是说他是等着伯多禄来给他进去，因为他们当伯多禄是他们的领袖，所以就不进去，就要尊重他，等到伯多禄来就给他进去先。无论如何他们进去，伯多禄什么反应都没有，只是看到什么东西没有。后来耶稣所喜爱的门徒也进去，那个字他看见就相信了，但是还没有说相信什么。他是相信耶稣复活了吗？还是相信玛利亚马达勒纳所说的话吗？还是相信什么？福音最后一段他们很清楚的说，那时候他们还不明白耶稣要从死中复活。所以如果他不明白，那时候不明白的句必须复活，那到底他们相信的是什么呢？是相信耶稣复活吗？如果你照这逻辑来讲，我们不明白的事我们能够相信吗？如果我们不相信我们不明白的东西，我觉得整个世界的人已经很假烂了，因为很多东西我们不明白的，宇宙整个宇宙的那些金星我们也不明白啊，宇宙怎么开始我们也不知道啊，不要讲那么远啊，我们自己的信仰圣山我们明白吗？我读了几年我也不明白啊，我是不能完全明白圣体圣血怎么圣化变成基督的圣体圣血的，我也无法解释啊，只能够解释到一点点。所以如果我们只是要相信我们所明白的事，那我们的信仰就是不会成长到哪里去了，因为耶稣也是说，反而看不见的相信的更有福。我们看见才相信，是不是说没有福，比那些更少。所以当这位门徒写他相信了，相信什么？就是可能相信遗体没有在那里，就是可能是基督的话已经实现了，就是他已经复活。虽然他不明白，他还是相信。我们也应该这样子。我们对信仰是很多问题的，很多很多很多问题。那些问题有些是没有答案的，但是我们还是要相信，因为我们就是相信天主的话。如果他是真理，他是生命，他是道路，那他留下来的教会，他留下来的教训教导也是真理，也是道路，也是生命。如果我们相信天主是那三样东西，我们也要相信教会是他的道理，他的生命，他的真理。我们有时候会怀疑，人是会怀疑的，这没办法，我们也是会问的，连神父修女也是会问，我们自己也是有时候有会问到底是假还是真的。我们只是能够抓住耶稣的手说我相信，我们没有办法。因为对一个人，如果我给你很多答案，如果一个人不相信，他会问到底的，他会一直问一直问一直问，因为他不相信。但是如果一个人相信的话， 他什么问题都不会问的，因为只有耶稣能够给我们完整的答案。所以今天复活期让我们像耶稣所喜爱的门徒一样，看见了就相信，不需要问太多问题，因为说问更多问题会更复杂，会更怀疑。所以用一个简单的信仰去相信基督的复活。Just a short sharing in English, and there are some English speakers. If you compare the readings, the gospel from yesterday and last night's vigil and today, you will see a bit of difference. Now, last night, the vigil talks about three women who went to the tomb to anoint the body of Jesus for burial. But they did not find his body there. But they found a young man dressed in white clothes. Presumably, it's an angel. But the angel told them Jesus has resurrected. But what was their reaction? No reaction, no nothing. Only surprise and fear. There is no faith, there is no certainty, just fear and surprise. If you look at today's gospel, which talks about Mary Magdalene going on the first day of the week to again, probably to anoint the body for burial again, she didn't see anybody. She just saw the stone removed from the tomb, and that was it. Just ran. You can imagine somebody running in that kind of condition, probably hysterical, going to Peter and the beloved disciple, trying to say something while breathing heavily as if she just ran a 500-kilometer marathon. It's hard, kind of hard to picture. But if you think of the situation, she's able to convince Peter and the beloved disciple to go. Now, they both ran together, but of course, being the younger one, the beloved disciple reached first. But he did not go into the tomb first. Now, a lot of commentators of old says that this shows the primacy of Peter as the leader of the disciples. So the beloved disciple was waiting for him in respect so that when Peter comes, he is allowed to go in first. But again, the reactions are different. Peter being Peter, no reaction. Just like, don't know what to make of it, blur, not sure. But what the beloved disciple saw, the phrase is, he saw and he believed. But what did he believe? Did he believe in the resurrection? Did he believe in what Mary Magdalene said? Did he believe in all accounts? Because at the end of the gospel says, they do not understand the meaning of the words, Jesus must be put to death and to rise again. They did not understand that. So my question just now when I spoke in Chinese was, do we believe in what we understand, or do we believe in what we do not understand? Now, if you want to say that we only believe what we can understand, then the whole world is in trouble, because a lot of things we don't understand. We don't understand the origin of the universe. We don't understand how the body works. We don't understand how a car works. So, but we still believe that it works. You don't have to go so far. Let's take the math, for example, or our faith. I don't know how to explain the Trinity, but do I believe? Yes. I can't explain the Eucharist fully. I can't explain transubstantiation fully. But do I believe? Yes, I do. Because faith is not about seeing. It is about believing. And Jesus himself said to Thomas in the later Gospels, blessed are those who do not see and yet believe. If we only want to believe what we understand, then our faith will never grow. The challenge is to believe in the words of Christ, which he left to us, the church, because he is the truth, the way and the life. And that is what the church is to us today. So our faith is placed in Jesus, in the church, which continues to lead us in this path of faith towards God. And that is what we must believe in. That is our faith. And we pray that the Holy Spirit will continue to guide us, to grant us that grace, to continue to believe as the beloved disciple did.